Very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are doing well. So today we are going to start a next chapter, chapter number 5, acids, bases and salts. So in this chapter we will discuss about these topics. The topics are introduction, acids, bases, salts, indicators and neutralization. Okay. So first we want to see why we all learn about acids, bases and salt. Why we need to learn about acid, bases and salts, and what are they, what are acids and what are bases, and how do they play an important role in our day-to-day life. So whenever something plays an important role in our day-to-day life, we want to learn more about them. So here you can see the things which we have used in our day-to-day life. So here I want to show you acid, bases and salt are not just limited to chemistry lab, but they are also present in our day-to-day life. So here I have some simple everyday things on the table. Alright, you can see here vinegar, tomato sauce, lemon, soap, sugar, salt, toothpaste, chalk and liquid soap. So let's start with the tomato sauce. Okay, so this one is a tomato sauce and it is made up of tomatoes and it has a sour in taste because tomato contain oxalic acid. So this is our first acid. Okay. So what are the other acids here? We all know lemon is a citrus fruit and it contains citric acid, right? So this is also a acid. Now any other acid that you see on the table? Yes, vinegar. Vinegar is also an acid and it contains acetic acid. Alright, so this is also an acid. Okay. Now let's take a look here and what are the bases here? The soap and the liquid soap, both are bases. Okay. The bar soap typically is made up of sodium hydroxide and the liquid soap typically is made up of potassium hydroxide. So both are bases. Alright. And did you know the toothpaste also contain a base? Okay, so this is also a base. Okay. Now let's take a look at what are the salts. So obviously the salt that you eat, this is NaCl, sodium chloride, and this is a salt, and you know that this chalk, it contains calcium carbonate. It is here only sugar is left because sugar is not an acid, not a base and not a salt. So I am gonna put this one as a separate group. So now that we have looked at some example of acids, some example of bases, some example of salts. Alright. So all these acids, bases, salt, we have used in our day-to-day life. So now look at the properties of each and how they differ from each other.